Hi guys, welcome back to my channel, and today we are going to talk about proofreading and everything related to proofreading. What is proofreading? How much you can earn with proofreading? What you have to actually do? How to land clients as a proofreader? We are going to talk about all of that. Okay, so stay with me till the end, guys. For those of you who are new to this channel, guys, I'm Chavi Agarwal. I'm a blogger, a YouTuber, a freelancer, and an online business coach. I create videos on working from home, freelancing, and making money online every single week. So if you haven't already, click on the red icon below and subscribe to my channel, guys, and let's get started. Guys, I understand that you have decided to freelance and you have chosen your niche as proofreading. Let me tell you guys one thing, proofreading is extremely profitable if you know English extremely well. So if you have grasp over this language, you can earn really well as a proofreader who works online, as a proofreader who works from home, and as a proofreader who has tons of clients across the globe. There are just two tips that I want to give any freelance proofreader who is watching this video. The first thing is that I would say, as a freelance proofreader, try to get clients outside of India because they are the ones who actually value proofreading as a skill and they will pay you a lot more than what Indian clients can. The second thing is to still niche down more than just a proofreader. What I mean by that is to select what kind of proofreader you want to be. Do you want to proofread in the health industry, in the finance industry, in the technology industry? What kind of proofreader do you want to be? So you can select a particular industry that you want to work with, like I said, healthcare, finance, investments, technology, etc. Or you can niche down with the kind of work that you want to do. Do you want to work with code transcripts, researchers, or white papers, books, fiction or non-fiction? What is it that you want to do? You can also club both of these things. You can say that you are going to work with researchers who write extensive research papers in the medical industry or researchers in the technology industry, and you can niche down on the basis of what kind of content you want to read plus what industry you want to work with. Okay, so the more you niche down, the more clarity you will have as to who you want to work with, who you want to reach out to, and who your marketing initiatives should target. Okay, so it's going to give you a lot of clarity. So these are my two cents. These are my two tips that can actually help you out as a beginner freelance proofreader to get clarity and to get the kind of clients that you want. So let's begin with the basics. What is a proofreading job? Now, a lot of people confuse proofreading with editing job. Now, I want to distinguish between both of them. Now, what happens is when some content is written, it is edited up right after. So, editing involves a lot more than proofreading. It involves deleting paragraphs, adding on paragraphs, reframing paragraphs. It would involve restructuring the whole thing, restructuring sentences, paragraphs sometimes, entire chapters sometimes. Editing is a lot more involved with what kind of content it is, what is written in the content, how it is presented, and all of that. So editing takes a lot more time than proofreading. Now, what is proofreading? Proofreading is when you are supposed to read the entire content and ensure that it is fine-combed entirely. It does not have punctuation errors, grammatical errors, typos, etc. So somebody writes the content, it's going to be edited, and once it is completely edited, it is sent for proofreading, and post proofreading it is going to be published. So proofreading is the last step to any content publishing. This is extremely important to understand, so you know that the job of proofreader is limited to ensuring that your content does not have stupid mistakes, stupid grammatical mistakes, stupid typos, stupid punctuation errors, anything which is related to all of that. So it is completely perfect. Your job is going to be reading the content and to ensure that none of these things occur. So as a proofreader, you are supposed to be doing this. Second question which a lot of you guys have is what kind of educational background you need to become a freelance proofreader. Now, a lot of companies that I've seen online who are hiring proofreaders require you to have a degree in English or in literature. So something like Bachelor in Arts completely works fine. Now, even if you don't have that, but you have a great knowledge of English, if you have grasp over this language, you can still apply for proofreader jobs. This is because the most important thing as a proofreader is your English. So if you have that skill, if you have that confidence, you can go ahead and apply, and these degrees won't matter. But besides all of that, you will need to learn one thing, and that is proofreading marks. Now, when you're going to proofread, you're not going to write what is the problem there, or you're not going to correct. So the one thing that you will need to learn is proofreading marks. Now, these are the marks that you're going to put on the content to let the other person know what kind of corrections you have done, what kind of mistakes were there. So there is one proofreading mark for typos, there are different kind of punctuation errors and different types of proofreading marks. You can Google proofreading marks and learn that. It is extremely simple, but you will need to learn how to use them because it is extremely important as a proofreader to know that. Now, the next question is, how much can you earn as an online proofreader? Now, as a beginner, you're going to be earning less. So you can expect somewhere around $10 an hour. This is because you don't have the experience right now. Once you start gaining experience, once you start scaling, you can charge as much as $40 to $50 an hour and make as much as $40,000 in a year. Okay, so that is the income potential of an online proofreader. Now, if proofreading does interest you, I'm going to leave a link to a free webinar in the description box below. You can grab it. It is by Caitlin Pyle, who is one of the most popular proofreaders out there, who was able to set up a part-time proofreading business and make more than $40,000 in a year. And she teaches that now. She shares all her secrets, and she has created this amazing 76-minute webinar where she shares a lot of her secrets. And watching that will give you a lot of clarity as to how to become a proofreader and whether or not you're fit for becoming a proofreader, which is very important. So go to the description box below and grab that free training if you haven't already. Now, the most important thing is how to get clients as a proofreader. Now, my first and the foremost recommendation is going to be LinkedIn. So I need you to do three things on LinkedIn. The first thing is to set up your service page. I have created a video on how to create the service page. So you can grab that video from here and start creating your services page. The second thing is to update your LinkedIn profile to showcase that you are a proofreader, what kind of work that you take, what are your skills, and that you're open for hiring. So you need to update your entire profile with keywords to ensure that whoever is searching to hire a proofreader can land on your profile. The third thing is to go to the job section and look for proofreading jobs, freelancing, contractual or part-time proofreading jobs, and apply to those jobs. So most of these things are remote in nature. When you're going to go to the LinkedIn jobs and you're going to search for it, you can also filter it via freelancing jobs, contractual jobs, and part-time jobs. So please do that if you're looking for any of that. If you're looking for a full-time job, don't bother because it's going to show you the full-time jobs first. Now, my only tip is that if a job has been there for more than a week, there is no point in applying because they have already received a lot of applications and your application might get lost. So if you are going to see something which has recently been uploaded, like in 24 hours or 48 hours or even 72 hours, go ahead and apply to that job immediately. The second place that you can find proofreading jobs is on proofreadingservices.com. It is an extremely popular website which is specifically created for proofreaders to get jobs. All you have to do is to apply and finish their 20 minutes proofreading test. So give your best, take some time to learn, take some time to prepare, and then give the test so that you can qualify in the very first attempt. You can expect somewhere around $14 to $16 per hour as a proofreader if you're going to be working with proofreadingservices.com. Now, there are a lot of such websites that give out proofreading jobs, and I have created an entire video on it talking about, I think, 5 to 6 more companies like that, and you can find it here. So go grab that, watch that, and check out those companies as well. The third way to find clients as a proofreader is to directly reach out to them. Okay, so there are two ways to directly reach out to them. If you know who your target client is, which you will know if you niche down entirely, create a list of the kind of people that you want to work with, the kind of businesses you want to work with, and get their email IDs and send them a cold email. Now, you are not supposed to send them a cut, copy, paste template. Personalize your email so that the person who's reading it knows it is only and only for them, and it wouldn't have, it cannot be used in multiple places. It cannot be just cut, copy, pasted and sent it to like thousands of people. So make sure that you take out the time to research the business that you're sending this email to. Personalize it enough so that the reader knows it is for them. This will ensure that you're going to get a reply, to get a response to your cold emails. Okay. Cold emails is also a numbers game. So if you're going to send out a cold email to 5 people and then come back and tell me that I did not get any response, it's not going to work like that. Send out at least 25 to 30 cold emails in a week and you will get responses. Okay. The second thing, start attending more conferences, start attending book conventions, author conventions, meet more people. These are the kind of people who need proofreaders. So if you can go out, attend such conventions, it will be great. Now with the pandemic, obviously it is a little bit difficult because such events are not happening anymore. So take out some time to be a part of online events. Online events on Meetup, Clubhouse, or similar platforms. Okay, so you can do that. But make sure that you're networking with the people who you want to work with. You are in and around those people, you're talking about your services. It is extremely important that you do that if you want to land your clients as an online proofreader. So this is all about proofreading. My tips about proofreading, how to find clients, what you can expect in terms of income, what are the kind of degrees that you are required, what you need to learn such as proofreading marks, what you need to do as a proofreader. Remember that proofreading is extremely different than editing. You can offer both of them. But if you can also be only a proofreader, that is profitable enough. Okay. So if you have any question, guys, all you have to do is to comment below and let me know. I hope this video helped you out. You can see 2 more videos on proofreading and freelancing on the screen right now. So make sure that you click on that and watch them. And I'll see you next week. Bye-bye.